Time now for our final off-the-record parting shots. Mike Miller, you're up first.
I think we're going to see with the new Attorney General, David Yost, a very, very aggressive Attorney General. David is one that has never stepped back from any issue or problem, and I think you'll see, again, a very aggressive 4 years in that office.
Dale.
As bad as the shutdown has been for Trump, things are about to get a whole lot worse, because early next month, the president's former lawyer and fixer, Michael Cohen, is going to testify publicly in Congress. What's he going to talk about? The payoffs to porn stars, the felonies that he says President Trump directed him to commit, and maybe some stuff about that Moscow hotel that Cohen was negotiating for Trump while Trump was running for president. This could be a John Dean moment, right. And we all know how Watergate turned out.
Julie.
I wrote a piece on the transition to the Mike DeWine administration. You know, we'll see a lack of volatility after things like the Trump presidency, which have been very volatile, and the case of governorship that we've talked about today. A lot of crazy things happened in the beginning of both of those administrations that I don't believe we're going to see here.
Kamala Waters, Kathy.
I'm hoping the DeWine administration will get to work on Medicaid and find out why 700,000 people have been removed from the rolls in the last year.
All right. John Kasich had a building named for him at the state fair, even though he refused to continue the tradition of spending a night at the state fair, like at the sheep barn or the dairy barn. We asked Mike DeWine this week if he would pick up that tradition. Apparently not. As of right now, Mike DeWine has no plans to do as Jim Rhodes did and spend the night at the State Fair, which is too bad for us and for late night comics.